Good afternoon, guys, and happy Thursday to all of your sunshiny faces. Guys, currently soaking the crock pot from dinner tonight. Because, you know, if you don't feel like washing something at night, you just let it soak overnight and then you wash it in the morning. Now, I'm normally waiting for my breakfast to cook anyway, so I normally wind up washing what's ever in the sink. So, yeah, that's why, you know, just got that going. But, it's actually kind of late. It's 11 o'clock. I think the Cubs game is maybe only in like the 6th or 7th inning or something like that right now, because there was a rain delay. So I think it was supposed to start 7. It was already like a late game, and it didn't end up, I don't know, starting till like maybe 8, maybe 9 o'clock. I don't totally know. Yeah, it's in the top of the 6th inning right now. So it's already kind of like gonna be a late night. I am probably gonna stay up to watch it, and I'm gonna make my grocery list so I don't have to worry about it tomorrow, because I told you guys too, Jack has like football, sort of like football practice sort of thing, which has to be a little bit different. So I guess like the linemen, because they can't participate in the, I think it's supposed to be a 7-on-7, which they can still do for the football practice, but they only have like 2 weeks or whatever. So, and I don't even know if that's gonna wind up happening today, but regardless, the practice is supposed to be at 7 o'clock. Sorry guys, I'm got something in the back of my throat. Actually, my mom got me a chocolate shake from McDonald's, and I have got, like I said, something like, it feels like when I have too much dairy sometimes that gets like that, like my throat gets all like I gotta keep clearing it. So anyways, because Jack has that, we are gonna go to still do our normal grocery shopping. Obviously, we should be home before 7 o'clock. We normally almost always have been, and it still should give us plenty of time. We will still go to most likely Caputo's and Jewel tomorrow, and I want to make sure that I have my grocery list done ahead of time, so I'm not like, oh, Dad, can we wait like 10 minutes till I finish my list so we can go to the store? Like, I want to make sure it's done, and I don't have to worry about any of that tomorrow in case, again, you know, something happens, I wake up late or something like that, or I don't, and maybe I completely forget to do my grocery list or something. I can just make sure it's done. So I'm going to work on that right now while I'm watching again the end of the Cubs game, since it's still going on. But the cool thing is that they're up. So that was nice. We watched the football game, which, like, Chiefs, cool. I kind of, you know, kind of not a Chiefs fan, but, you know, I rooted for him in the Super Bowl last year, and, you know, like, I was a Patrick Mahomes fan, but he was kind of not so cool to my Bears, and so, you know, there was that. But anyways, I like the Texans. I was a J.J. Watt fan, so, you know, but I don't know. It wasn't like I was like, oh, I definitely want them to win, or I definitely want that team to win, you know, like I was really rooting for it, and it was an okay game, you know, kind of paid attention, but I was like, oh, football's back, like, you know, that whole kind of thing. But it wasn't like, oh my gosh, it was like amazing, you know, like it was a pretty okay game, I guess. So I was watching that, and then I was also switching, and I was watching the US Open, because I told you guys I watched it yesterday. I was watching Serena Williams, and I watched it again today. But yeah, I probably won't be watching much more. I don't know actually if any US players are left anymore. Because I was trying to think, I think the game right before that wasn't, and this game wasn't either. So I don't, like I said, I don't know. And I don't actually know who else is like in it yet. So anyways, I'm not like a huge tennis fan. I just like Serena Williams. So yeah, but anyways, I'm gonna work on my grocery list, guys. Me and Jack, though, we're having a very fun conversation. We're having one of our typical MCU conversations over, our biggest one is normally we're arguing about the new Spider-Man movies. We're normally arguing about, I don't know, my biggest hang-up, me and Jack both totally like fall on opposite sides of this conversation all the time. Normally it's that for me, I personally don't always feel like the two new Spider-Man movies, that they take place enough in New York. Like, I don't know, for me, like, I grew up watching the Tobey Maguire Spider-Man movies, and to me those were very like New York, like it felt like New York to me watching those movies. And then these, like, obviously the second one almost takes place nowhere near New York, and even in the first one too, like, there wasn't, like, he's on a trip for half the movie, like, there's not a lot of him being in New York, and he, you know, like, is the friendly neighborhood Spider-Man, like, he gives up, like, being sort of, you know, a member of the Avengers to be friendly neighborhood Spider-Man, and the movies to me don't feel like they take place enough in New York for, like, him to, like, justify, like, giving that up. Like, there's no, like, just, like, I don't know, like, it doesn't take place enough in New York for me. So anyways, we totally fall on different sides of that. Jack's like, no, but you have to understand what's going on. And I'm like, dude, I totally get it. But, like, to me, like, okay, there was an origin story, which is totally fine. But, like, I want to see more of New York. And so anyways, again, we totally fall on different sides. And we argue this point all the time. We're actually talking about something completely different and somehow ended up getting on that. So then I was trying to explain to him, because he's never seen the Tobey Maguire Spider-Man movies. I only saw the Andrew Garfield Spider-Mans. I only saw the second one. I didn't see the first one. They both saw, I think, both of them in theaters. Like, everybody else actually saw both of them in theaters, and I didn't see either of them. Until I saw the second one on TV, like, maybe a couple of years ago. And then I ended up, again, we had all three, I think, of the Spider-Man movies, the Tobey Maguire ones on DVD. The first and the second one we watched on repeat. like, that was, like, Matthew was so in love with Spider-Man. He wanted to be Spider-Man when he was little. I kid you not from watching those movies. Like, we watched those probably more than, like, Disney movies. Like, Disney princess movies, for me, were, like, Matthew's was watching Spider-Man. And so, again, we saw the second one in theaters and the third one. And we saw the Fantastic Four Silver Surfer movie in theaters, too. So, like, I saw a lot of those. Like, once the MCU, like, actually, I never saw any of those movies up until I saw Ant-Man at home one time randomly. But I had never seen any of those movies up until 2 years ago, I think. Or whatever it was, 2 or 3 years ago. But again, like, I watched... You know, like I said, I lived on watching those Tobey Maguire movies over and over and over and over again. Just Matthew was in love with them, and I didn't mind watching them either. Like, I liked them. So anyways, Jack has never seen them. So I was trying to explain to him today a couple of the, not iconic scenes, but I feel like if I were to have been explaining this to Matthew, he'd be like, yes, I totally know what you were saying. Just because it wasn't a really easy way to just, like, explain it. I was trying to explain to him the cranberry scene when, like, Peter Parker is going to go and get the cranberries or whatever. And that's when, what's his face? Like, kind of figures out who Spider-Man is. Green Goblin figures out who Spider-Man is. And again, anybody that has watched those movies as many times as probably me and Matthew have would totally understand what I was talking about. Jack was like, I was like, yes, that's the cranberry scene. And he's like, what are you even talking about? And so we were bawling because, like, I was trying so hard to explain to him this movie scene that he's never seen. And it was hilarious. And then on top of that, too, I was also trying to explain to him that I realized I was actually doing a different scene. The one where... Green Goblin's also trying to lure Peter Parker into the burning building, and he's got the cloak thing on. He's trying to be an old lady. That one I was also trying to explain that one to him, and I was using a prop. I was using the blanket as a prop. And then that actually turned into General Palpatine from Star Wars. And then it turned into I was trying to also explain the second movie to him, the one with Doc Ock. I think he's seen the third one. So, and I didn't see that one maybe as many times. I still saw it a bunch, but again, the second one. So I was trying to explain that one to him as well. I was trying to explain to him the Doc Ock arms and the part in the surgery room. I was trying to explain to him the little thingy on the back of his neck. And I was like, I kept doing this too because that's what he does in the movie scene. And, like, again, I've seen it so many times. So I was like, that part where he's like this with the little thingy on the back of his neck so that the arms don't, like, just come alive. So I was trying to explain to him that, and then the other part I was trying to explain to him was, I think it's in the second one, I can't remember if it's the second or the first one. Like Aunt May's going to try and open a bank account or something like that, and she's trying to get the free toaster, and she brings a little newspaper clipping to like show like, I should get a free toaster when I open the bank account. And they're like, no, you don't have enough money to put in the account or something like that. I don't totally remember it by heart. But I was trying to explain to him that. I was like, yeah, that's the part where she's like, hey, I get the free toaster. So now we have to watch those movies just because I have tried so hard to explain to him what these are, and we were dying laughing. Because again, he hasn't seen them, and I feel like, again, my random, like, because it has been probably a good 10 years maybe since I actually have seen the movies. So again, I me trying to explain from my watching them so much, but my vague, like, not seeing them recently at all, me trying to explain kind of parts to him. And because again, we're having this discussion about the new Spider-Man movie, so I was trying to explain to him some of the old Spider-Man stuff and like how, like, to me it made me feel, because again, watching it when I was little and growing up and all that kind of stuff. So as I'm trying to explain this to him and he's not getting it, and then I'm trying to be like, well, this scene where, you know, there's this toaster scene, or this scene where there was a cranberry scene, and I'm like trying to explain all this stuff to him, and he's like, yeah, we were just like dying laughing. Because again, if I was explaining this to Matthew, he'd be like, yes, I understand what you're talking about. Like, I don't know, we were just, because me and Matthew are closer in age, so like we're on the same wavelength. Like, you know, we kind of grew up as like that same, like, as little kids, me and Jack are so much further apart in age. Like, we didn't grow up with the same experiences, so me trying to explain that to him is like, again, me and Matthew are sort of like, we almost read each other's minds, you know, sort of thing. And then, like, you know, when I'm trying to explain something, he's like, yeah, 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 I know what you're talking about. And like, Jack's like, I have no clue what you're saying. So I feel like it's sort of a rite of passage, at least in our house. Because again, my mom, like, at one point, I'm pretty sure if I rewatched the movie, I could probably recite both of the first two movies for you guys, if I rewatched it and refreshed my memory. But right now I'm still like, oh yeah, that was that part, or like, this was this part, and I'm like, everything's trying to come back, but I couldn't remember exactly everything. So yeah, it was pretty hilarious me trying to explain all this to Jack and trying to act out the scenes too at the same time. I was trying to do that, so I think that's partially why my voice is almost gone today. I was also jamming out to some music in my room. I feel like that's also possibly why my voice is like I said too, and I had that milkshake too. So anyways, guys, I'm gonna go make my grocery list. I'm gonna go watch the end of the Cubs game, but I thought I'd just share with you guys our hilariously funny our conversation for today and what we're planning on possibly doing. But there's a bunch of football games and sports games on this weekend, so I was like, maybe I can't do it this weekend. And Jack obviously had to go to bed early. It's 11 o'clock right now, and he's already been in bed for a little while because he has school tomorrow. So and I don't know what's going on, because like, he has like, the school's supposed to start at like normal, like 7 o'clock, but like up until 10 o'clock he has free time, which is where like, I guess they can ask teachers questions, like all this kind of stuff. But I was like, what do you ask them on the first day of school, like, if there's no lesson that's been taught already? So like, he's like, yeah, I don't know, like, am I still supposed to sign in for that, or like, you know, is that just like a free period where like, you know, you don't, if you know, you work on your work and stuff like that, and you're obviously struggling, you can contact your teachers and stuff like that. But obviously on the first day you have nothing, so like, I have no clue. But he's like concerned about that too, and he's like, I have to make sure I'm up early enough, you know, for the class and all that kind of stuff. And you know, but he doesn't actually have a class that starts at 7. So anyways, guys, I am gonna, like I said, get this all taken care of, but I'll see you guys all in tomorrow's vlog. If you guys did enjoy today's, make sure you guys give a little thumbs up. If you guys are new, we'd love if you'd subscribe, and I'll see all of your sunshiny faces tomorrow. So bye, guys.